I'm Dr. Coleman Martin, an interventional neurologist at the St. Luke's Brain and Stroke Institute in Kansas City, Missouri. This is Interventional Stroke Rounds. Today we have a patient in her mid-50s. Shortly after awakening, she discovered left-sided weakness and numbness. She's within 3 hours of the beginning of her stroke symptoms. A head CT does not yet show damage, nor is there bleeding within the brain. There's a good chance she may be helped with the clot-busting medicine TPA. She was given the medicine, but unfortunately, it did not cure her stroke. Quickly, we performed a CT angiogram to help identify the blocked artery. The blocked blood vessel is too small to clearly see. We need a better test. A CT perfusion scan clearly shows an area of brain that is not getting sufficient blood flow. Green means the brain tissue is still alive and may be helped by restoring blood flow. I started an emergency angiogram entering her arterial system at her left groin. I passed a catheter, a small plastic tube, from her femoral artery up the aorta and into her right internal carotid artery. These are the arteries of the right side of her brain. We are looking for a vessel that flows slowly or stops prematurely due to a clot. Looking closely, we can see that there is a medium-sized branch that does not flow properly. Now magnified, we can see that the blood flow stops here. To illustrate, let's look at the middle cerebral artery of another patient. I highlighted the blocked branch that we need to open in our stroke patient to help her symptoms of numbness and weakness. To open the branch, we're going to use a Penumbra aspiration catheter. Through it, I will pass a separator that will break up the clot. The catheter is connected to suction to pull away pieces of the clot. The tip of the separator is very soft and doesn't traumatize the vessel. Let's look at the Penumbra system in a flow model. Once the catheter engages the clot, it can quickly clear the vessel. To the left, you see what the catheter and separator look like under X-ray. While the clot may not show up under X-ray, our images tell us where we need to work. I have advanced the aspiration catheter into the affected branch. Now, moving the separator back and forth across the clot, we can try to break up the clot and carry pieces away with suction. I will inject some contrast to see if the vessel has opened up. Nope, not yet. I will work some more with the catheter and separator. Now we are starting to get some flow through the branch. Let's keep at it. I will make several more passes back and forth across the clot. Our goal is to clear as much of the clot as we safely can, if possible, fully restoring flow. Now the vessel is flowing much better, maximizing her chances for a recovery. This case illustrates that going to a hospital where you can receive the clot-busting drug TPA is not always enough to successfully treat a stroke. At St. Luke's Hospital, we're available for interventional stroke therapy day and night. If you or a family member has a stroke, we have you covered. I hope you found this interesting. At St. Luke's Hospital, we care about stroke and interventional education. Feel free to share this video on your blog, Facebook, and Twitter. Another stroke, gotta go.